What's up, guys? You're tuned in to another Rappler Live Jam from home. My name is Amanda, and here with me right now is, or are, John and RV of The Aviators. The Aviators or Aviators? May the ba yun or what?
Wala, walang daw. Walang daw.
Aviators. They are The Aviators. Hi, guys!
Hi.
Welcome to Rappler Live Jam.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah, so we'll be hearing your music later on. But for now, I'm going to grill you, joke. But yeah, I'll ask you a few questions. So I guess to begin with, what's the story behind your band name or duo?
Me and RV are very good fans of The Last Shadow Puppets, if you're familiar. So that is a side project of Alex Turner from the Arctic Monkeys. And it was a very good song on their second album named Aviation. And I guess that's where it kind of came from. I mean, I'm not going to give you some kind of deep ass story about it because it's pretty, I don't know, it's pretty surface level. It's just a song I really like. And we just tweaked it in a way to kind of fit a band.
Yeah. Mm. Simple as that. I mean, most band names are.
Yeah. Yeah.
Kala naman, oh, ano story behind this? Pero,
wala.
It's really...
Wala.
Basically, they're a duo. So, I mean, we love the idea of being like a duo. So, I think that's where it stems from.
Yeah. Parang naisip na imagine ko today, like, you're like in a cockpit and, you know, there's a pilot and a co-pilot. So,
yeah.
Ganong level.
It works then. Because if you see, like, how we look, I guess, or you know how we dress and our branding materials, there's an element of it being vintage. Yeah. And I guess Aviator is a bit of a vintage thing to hear and to imagine.
Yeah, the shades and stuff.
Yeah.
It works.
Or like World War II.
Yeah, World War
II. Ako naman, play bands. Anyway. So you guys first came together in 2009. That was so long ago. How you started as like a high school cover band. How did that happen? Like who approached who? How did you start playing together?
When we started in 2009, you're right. It's like a, you know, those high school cover bands who play like Sweet Child of Mine.
Yeah.
Like, how it happened is I think we were second year high school and merong Battle of the Bands. And I was actually the drummer for that band, to be honest. I don't remember who met who, but maybe
yeah,
you remember.
I do, yeah. I think we were asked to like form a band, and then okay, we were looking because we're in Iloilo in our school dati. We didn't have a lot of drummers, and then this one kid from another section, he plays drums. So me and a friend of mine, we actually went to their classroom and then, you play drums.
I remember.
Yeah.
To give background, Amanda, we're from Iloilo.
Yeah, we're from Iloilo.
Cool. Tapos both of you went to Manila and like continued like the music thing. The music thing.
Well, actually, I'm still from Iloilo.
Yeah. He still lives in Iloilo. Yeah.
Wait, so LDR kayo?
Yeah, LDR songwriting. Basically.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Okay, so now that we're like talking about your songwriting, how does that go that you're in Iloilo, and then John's here.
Just throw around ideas and then mix our acts. We basically love like the same bands, the same type of music, the same what we want to like to hear in our own sound. So yeah, basically we pass around lyrics and stuff.
It's a very free flowing process.
Yeah,
I mean, sometimes I'll send a song, or let's do something that sounds like this. And then maybe RV can start the lyrics and I'll arrange it or vice versa. I mean, there is no set up process to it. It's very free flowing.
Mm-hmm.
Because I think constraining it to a certain process might hinder the creativity a bit.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But do you like have parang a goal na parang, okay, today we have to write a song or we have to write one song a week? Or do you
no,
do that?
No, no. It
wow,
just
so
comes and goes. Gotta grasp it.
Very artistic. So
yeah.
You started writing, I mean you started as a cover band, but you so like it's so interesting that that's where you started because most high school cover bands parang you know they play at one gig at the school fair and then wala na. But you guys are like still here, still playing, and you started making your own music pa in 2016.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So do you remember like the first song that you guys wrote?
Well, just to go back a bit, after high school, we didn't really like play.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So after that, we're always in contact and stuff, but we've never really like played together live. And in terms of the first song. Well, first song recorded is yeah. I Got You.
Yeah.
But that's very recent. That's just a 2019 song. The stuff from 2016, if I'm being honest with you, Amanda, I don't really remember where they are right now. It's a baul.
Buried somewhere.
Yeah, gotta dig it up again.
But how did that come about? Like, were you just parang, okay, let's start writing our own songs now?
Hindi. Oh. Wala lang eh. It's just like, we never really put a, like a end goal to it. You know what I mean? I mean, we both mm-hmm. like music and we've always wanted to write stuff. So we just started writing.
Yeah.
You know, we didn't expect it to be honest with you, we didn't expect it to be released or anything.
Yeah. Mm.
Well, to be, well, for us, the writing process for like, let's say I Got You. Cause I was toying with the idea of writing like a short film, and then okay, it's not gonna work. So I sent him an idea, and then we kind of, because we have really we have good friends that we, oh sorry, not, cut. Okay, we have good. Ulit. Okay, because we have a tight knit group of friends. When we were in high school, so we would have this annual trip, like a trip of ours. So I Got You, we were in Baguio, and then that's where we finished the song.
Yeah, it was actually meant to be like some kind of storyline for maybe a short film,
yeah.
But
right.
We just turned it into a song.
Yeah,
madali.
Like from a film to a song.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I guess go ahead.
Okay. Well, our what do you call this? Our creative outlets are spread across very wide.
Yeah.
I mean, we're both advertising creatives, Din, mm-hmm. and we like a lot of film. I think that helps a lot in trying mm-hmm. to create certain artworks because you're not just stemming from one medium.
Yeah.
Creativity is translatable. It's translatable. So it can be like we have expressions through photography, graphic design, film, and different mediums as well.
Doesn't that drain you at some point? Like, I mean, you mentioned that you're both also working in advertising as creatives.
Hmm.
Like, never ba nauubos yung creativity nyo?
It helps.
Yeah.
I don't think I would have made these songs without being in advertising because it keeps the mind sharp.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
Honestly.
And it kind of improves your sanity. Because it's like if you're creatively drained in this part or like in this section, and then you can just transfer, work on another creative thing, and then just go back to it's the solution to creative rut, basically.
Mm.
Amen.
Ang ganda. So like for any creative, I guess that's an interesting piece of advice. Na parang engage in different types of creative outlets.
So, yeah, kasi kung isa lang, it's going to drain you.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. Oh, interesting. I like that. So, you guys, parang it sounds like from what you've made kwento, from what you've said so far, parang this is something you didn't plan, like you didn't plan to like really go pro with this or like parang you were just doing it out of joy and out of the love for music. Yeah. But now you're here, you're about to release or you're working on your debut album and you've been nominated for an AWIT award. Like, what does that feel like? Na parang it's becoming something, I guess, bigger than what you expected.
it's very affirming, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure you would know, since creatives naman tayo dito lahat, na at the end of the day, we want people to like what we do, mm-hmm. you know. So stuff like that is just, you know, motivation and affirmation that you're making a difference, badly put, in the world. As hopeless as that might sound.
Hindi
ba nakaka-pressure though? Like, okay, parang it's, you know, bigger audience bigla and yeah. Mm.
No. Honestly, parang it's we don't really put too much pressure on ourselves. I wouldn't even say we're going pro, if you ask me.
Yeah.
It's really another creative outlet. And at the end of the day, we create music for no one else but ourselves.
Yeah. If people like it, then they like it. If they don't, they don't. Just,
mm-hmm.
The important thing is we like our stuff.
We make music mm-hmm. we want to listen to,
yeah,
basically.
Yeah. Amen.
Nice. So you're working on your debut album nga. Analogies on Love, that's what it's called. Grabe naman yung title. Like, what's the story behind that title?
It's basically because every song, if you ask me, every song in the album is some kind of literal analogy on love.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, I think that's kind of the writing style we've adopted. It's I would kind of call it abstract writing, in a way that it's not a linear story that you would expect from maybe a novel or something, but it's a combination of words and sounds that evoke feeling.
Yeah.
And you've been working on it for the last, like, how long have you been working it on it now?
It's actually done.
Oh, okay.
Kalo we worked on it from March.
March.
Oh, wait.
The whole March. Wait.
No.
During the pandemic.
We wrote it during the pandemic. Then we recorded it March. Yeah, and then we mixed it for about 3 months.
Mm-hmm. What changed in your songwriting process and in your music, like when you were working mm-hmm. on this album?
From what you'll hear later on, it's the songs are a bit more, not a bit, they're actually very energetic.
Yeah.
In a way, when we started out, our songs were a bit broody, very edgy or dramatic or whatever. But now, if I were to put into a sentence what the album is, it's basically a party.
Ooh, okay, so it's like dancey in a way.
A bit. It's very, very strong. It smacks you in the face, basically.
Mm. All right. So that is coming out when? Can you say that?
I can say for sure next year. We can probably expect the first single first quarter.
Okay.
That's all I know for.
So people can wait for that first quarter of 2022 on online, on social media. Like, where can people find you?
Oh, social media. I mean, we have Facebook, we have Instagram. And if they follow us, they'll know when something's happening.
Google Aviators everywhere. Aviators band.
Yeah.
And they'll find you.
Yep.
So, now that your album is done and you're just waiting for it to come out, what else are you guys up to?
What are we up to? Well, we're up to this. After this interview, you can expect to be rocked.
Mm.
Your socks will be rocked off.
But beyond this interview, what's next from Aviators?
To be honest with you, Amanda, it's the album.
Yeah, album.
It's the album.
We take it step by step long.
Yeah. Yeah, so after
the flow.
So after this performance, maybe a few months, and expect things to kind of kick off, you know, and maybe we'll get a date for when the first single is coming out.
Yay. Okay, so in the meantime, like, it's time for people to really get to know you guys and listen to your music. So yeah, we'll head on to your performances now. But thank you guys for chatting with me and for sharing your process and your music with us. Good luck with everything.
Thank you.
I appreciate it. Thanks for having us on.
Thanks for being here. And to everyone who's tuned in, thank you for tuning in to Live Jam. Enjoy the music of Aviators. We'll be right back.
Okay, that's it for this one. Tama na. Amen.
Hand grenade. Explode.